I just did this, took like an hour, sadly. But I'm gonna show you guys how to make it take 10 minutes or less. So I'm gonna be using the LA Girl concealer in the color Fawn as my eyelid base, of course. And I'm not gonna be taking too much because I need the base to sort of be dry and not sticky because it's gonna be moving too much. All right, that's all the time we're gonna wait for it to get to set. And I'm just gonna take my brush and I'm going to pat this in until it gets basically dry, like super dry. So after it gets super dry, I'm gonna be taking my Huda Beauty powder in the shade Kunafa, if you didn't watch, if you haven't watched like my recent videos. Tapping, I'm only gonna take a little bit, like this much, and setting my eyes. Just a little bit to the eyeshadow. I'm trying to make this as quick as possible. So I use two palettes, of course, the best palettes that you can use for the fall. Morphe 3502 and Jaclyn Hill palette, but they discontinued the 3502, sadly, and double the price if you try and buy it on like a different website. So I'm so sorry if you don't have this palette because this is a staple. So I'm gonna be using this color. It came with like the color names, but I'm just gonna point to it. I'm gonna use this color as my transition, right? Yeah, that's what I used. I'm gonna be patting this in, not blending, patting it in for the most maximum color. So patting this in. This color is just nice as hell in general. So I'm gonna be taking the Jaclyn Hill palette and I'm gonna be taking the shade. This color, this deep red, on a crease brush. I'm gonna be packing it over the orange, if I can find my crease brush that I used. So I'm gonna be patting it in like a smoky eye. I'm not gonna just put it in my crease. Of course, blend that out. Last but not least, I'm gonna be taking this color, of course, this perfect brown, and I'm gonna be patting this over the reddish color, but not too high because I have to blend all this out. I'm not trying to look crazy. All right, avoid this part. I'll fix that after I'm done with all my eyeshadow because I need to move on. So I'm gonna be taking Porcelain. I always look at this color like I don't use it all the time, but this is Porcelain. I'm gonna be cutting my crease. Oh shit, this is the wrong brush. I don't know how to explain this type of cut crease, so I guess I'll just show it in accelerated version, I guess. I don't know. The lighting might be bad for a little bit. Yeah. Right, so hopefully you guys saw how I did that because I don't know how to explain it. Then I'm gonna be taking the brush I accidentally used, which was my small packing brush. I'm gonna be, shit, O2, this matte color. And packing this like a beach. I don't know. I'm gonna be taking my NYX glitter in the color, I'm pretty sure it's like crystal gold. Yeah, crystal gold. I'm gonna take this lightly because lightly is equal to the exact amount that you need. So I don't want it to look like I have a chunky ass line of glitter. All right, so I'm gonna go like blend this, the top out real quick. I just use the same brush I used with my concealer to like smooth out the edges. So we can look a lot of these because this look crazy. So I'll be back. All right, the best time is the face time. I actually like my eyeshadow. I did some eyeliner off camera and I added these lashes from AliExpress. So My face routine is always the same thing, but I feel like I have to put this in the video just in case people don't watch the video before. So today I want a really smooth, silky base. So of course I use my Angel Veil and the pore filler. Angel Veil first and then the pore filler on top. So this is getting a little oily. Face feels soaky. So then I'm gonna take my pore filler by NYX right on top of it. This shit's mad dry. I hate when it starts getting cold outside because my face starts getting lighter. Then I have to switch my foundations. I have to switch the finish, the feel, switch the primers. Ugh, my face is so dry right now. All right, now I'm gonna take my Huda Beauty powder. Not because I need it, not because I need. I'm going to be taking my Huda Beauty because I'm going to be using my Smashbox, which is a hydrating foundation, and I have oily skin, so. I'm taking this. Why is she so fucking brown, bitch? I'm going to be taking my Smashbox because my Huda Beauty is a little bit too matte and too dry for how cold it is outside. And I stepped outside the last time, and I was a whole different skin color and my face was dry as fuck, so I need a hydrating foundation that's not gonna make me too oily, which is a Smashbox. So I'm taking the Smashbox on my regular NYX number 3 brush. I feel like I have the same face routine, but I feel like I have to show it just in case. Maybe patting that in. You can see how warm and how nice this foundation. Okay, let me stop talking before this video is 30 minutes long. This foundation, I'm in the shade 4.35 skin tone, the color deep, the undertone cool. So spot on, spot on. I just laid already. I'm gonna be taking my smaller Real Techniques Expert Face Brush, the OG. And getting the little nooks and crannies. Okay, so what I've been noticing lately is that I have more halo brow than expected. So the only thing that I really change is that when I put my fawn on, like around my face to conceal, I literally leave it on for as long as I keep my concealer around my eyebrows, which is like a good, what, like 30 minutes before I actually start applying foundation. But we don't have 30 minutes to spare right now. Class is at 1 and it's 12:25, so I'm gonna go kill two birds with one stone. I'm gonna finish concealing and then put on my clothes for class because I am not dressed. Pack my bag and shit. So that'll probably be like 10 minutes. I'm gonna keep this on my face because I want everything to be highlighted. I don't want just my eyebrows floating on my face. So the longer you keep it on, the more it'll match my eyebrows, and then everywhere it's highlighted and it'll eliminate my halo brow situation. Hopefully my camera's focused, but it's been 10 minutes. I put on my fit wearing. If you guys know me, I wear very comfortable clothes to class. I don't do the most. So I'm wearing these red sweatpants and a hoodie and some soft boots like Mini Tonkas. So I'm gonna blend this out and it just provides so much more coverage instead of just blending into the foundation and disappearing like a magic trick. So you guys can see how my face is highlighted right now because I left the concealer on, right? So I'm gonna be taking the brush and then blending out the edges as much as I can. Taking my small brush that I use for my foundation and making that blend in perfectly. So then I'm gonna do my contour. I'm not gonna do too much today because my face is warm as butt. Probably like that much. This is the Maybelline Fit Me foundation stick in the color Espresso. Yup. Put a little bit here, a little bit on my nose. Same shit. I'm gonna take my stipple brush from e.l.f., a small stipple brush got off of what's it called? Amazon. I don't know if they still sell these in store, but I got this off Amazon for like $1 or $3, something like that. I think it's $1. And now to blend everything together, I'm gonna be taking my Huda Beauty, of course, because this is yellow based, so it's gonna keep my warmth, but it's also gonna like tone it down just a little bit versus using like a darker powder like my Laura Mercier. My face would have been red as thick. So, got some separation. Alright, I'll just put, I don't know how I got that. I never got separation. Oh, there's something in my powder. I'm a dumb bitch. But I'll just put beauty marks on that fake beauty mark. I never got separation in my powder, so nobody comes for this powder because it's the goat. And then with the excess, I'm gonna pat my contour. Contour brush. Just pat it in everywhere. And of course, I'm gonna set. Where's my blush palette? I'm gonna set my contour with this. I think I'm only gonna take a little bit today, like that much, because my face is doing the most right now. I just need to set it. Plus some setting spray, do something to my bottom lash, fix the separation, and I'll be back. I don't know what color lip color I want to wear yet, but I'll think about it. All right, so I used this Ruby Kisses brown lipstick and then Corset in NYX Liquid Lip Lingerie, and this is basically the finished product. I put some highlight from Carly Bible palette. So I put some highlight on. So I did a full ass face, and I'm about to go to class. I'm about to go to physics with a full ass face, even though I do that every day. But this is basically the finished product. Yes, I'm going to class with a bun on my head. But let me know what you guys think about this. And I finally did this glam. Like, I feel I've been doing boring ass looks on my channel, and I did lipstick, eyeliner. Like, I'm happy. But let me know what you guys think about this look and the products that I use, and any type of video you guys want to see, let me know down below, and I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm about to be late to class. Bye.